It's been a hectic day of diplomacy. Prime Minister Modi's visit to Ukraine was brief, just 7 hours long. Despite that, there were some significant outcomes. On the war, India reaffirmed its support for a diplomatic solution. Prime Minister Modi said that he is willing to help and facilitate this dialogue. Plus, a total of 4 agreements were signed, including a pact on humanitarian assistance for Ukraine. And finally, India delivered a strong message to the opponents of its independent foreign policy. Let's bring you the highlights. Prime Minister Modi arrived early this morning in Kiev. He took an overnight train from Poland, spending 10 hours on the Rail Force One. He was welcomed by Ukraine's first Deputy Foreign Minister. Prime Minister Modi was not travelling alone, of course. 2 of his top cabinet colleagues accompanied him, External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar and National Security Advisor Ajit Doval. From the train station, they went to the Hyatt Hotel in Kiev. There, members of the Indian community greeted him. Prime Minister Modi's first stop was the Gandhi statue in Kiev. This bronze statue was unveiled in 2020. Modi paid a homage to the Mahatma there. The Prime Minister's next stop was more significant, the National Museum of History, where he was greeted by Ukraine's President Volodymyr Zelensky. Both leaders were there to witness an exposition set up in the memory of the children who lost their lives in the war. Prime Minister Modi greeted Zelensky with a hug and placed a toy in the memory of the victims. This gesture by the Indian Prime Minister is quite significant. Remember, he'd met the Russian President 6 weeks ago. In that meeting, Modi raised the death of children with Putin. This was right after a children's hospital in Kiev was targeted. Russia had conducted a lethal missile strike. More than 40 people, including 4 children, had died in that attack. Now, Modi met Putin a day after that, and he said that the death of innocent children was, quote-unquote, painful and terrifying. The same sentiment was conveyed in his meeting with Zelensky today.
लेकिन जब आज मैं उन बालकों की स्मृति में बनाए हुए म्यूजियम को आपके साथ जाकर के अपने श्रद्धा सुमन अर्पित कर रहा था तो मेरा मन भर आया था, दिल को गहरी चोट पहुंची थी और मुझे लगता है कि युद्ध की सबसे पहली ग्रेजुएट किसकी होती है तो निर्दोष बालकों की होती है और वो बहुत दर्दनाक होता है.
In that spirit, Modi urged Zelensky to start a dialogue to end this conflict. The Indian Prime Minister has made this appeal in the past as well to both Zelensky and Putin. 2 years ago, he told Vladimir Putin that this is not the era of war. During his visit to Moscow last month, he again stressed the need for dialogue. And today, Prime Minister Modi made a personal appeal to Zelensky.
हमने बिना समय गवाए उस दिशा में आगे बढ़ना चाहिए. दोनों पक्षों को साथ बैठ करके इस संकट की घड़ी से बाहर निकलने के रास्ते तलाशने होंगे. मैं आपको विश्वास दिलाना चाहता हूँ कि शांति के हर प्रयास में भारत अपनी सक्रिय भूमिका निभाने के लिए तैयार है. व्यक्तिगत रूप से मैं भी अगर इसमें कोई योगदान कर सकता हूँ तो मैं जरूर करना चाहूँगा. एक मित्र के रूप में मैं आपको विश्वास दिलाता हूँ.
Zelensky did not get a chance to respond to that, at least not in the front of the press, because Prime Minister Modi was speaking after Zelensky's opening remarks. Zelensky called the Indian leader's visit historic. He also hinted that India could play a role in ending this war. But here's the catch. Zelensky wants a truce on his terms. He wants India to endorse his peace plan.
The matter of ending the war and a just peace is the priority for Ukraine. We held the first inaugural peace summit. I want to thank India for being present at this summit. We expect India to join the joint communique of inaugural summit. I will talk about it with the Prime Minister.
Zelensky is referring to the peace summit, the one that was held in June this year. India had sent a delegation to this event. Russia was not part of it. They had not been invited. And for that reason, India refused to sign the joint communique. Now, New Delhi believes that for any peace proposal to succeed, both sides will have to agree to it. Prime Minister Modi maintained this position during the bilateral talks today. India and Ukraine have agreed to keep talking. Modi has invited Zelensky to visit India. Ukraine says it wants India to be part of the solution. It wants India to attend the next peace summit as well. This request was reiterated in the joint statement issued by both sides. Plus, there were other outcomes from these talks. Like I said, four bilateral agreements were signed. They cover areas like humanitarian assistance, agriculture, medicines and drugs, and cultural cooperation. So these are the broad takeaways. The leaders are said to have had a frank discussion, an exchange of opinion, particularly on issues where Ukraine has held grievances against India, like India's purchase of Russian oil. Minister Jaishankar reiterated India's position on this matter, and yet again he took a subtle jibe at the West.
It's not like there's a political strategy to buy oil. There is a oil strategy to buy oil. There's a market strategy to buy oil. So the figures of where we get our oil imports go up and down. It depends on the state of the market. But it would definitely, I think, the fact that the market is tight, that today big suppliers like Iran and Venezuela, who used to supply India, are constrained from operating freely in the markets.
That's a reference to Western sanctions on Iranian and Venezuelan oil. Jaishankar said India's purchases are necessary to meet the needs of Indians. They also play a role in the stability of the global markets. He also responded to Western criticism of Prime Minister Modi's trip to Russia.
In our part of the world, when people meet people, they are given to embracing each other. It may not be part of your culture, but I assure you it's part of ours. So, in fact, today I think I saw the Prime Minister also embrace President Zelensky, and I've seen him do it with a number of other leaders in a number of other places. So I think perhaps we have a slightly cultural gap here in terms of what these courtesies mean.
That's how the West views Prime Minister Modi's visits to Ukraine and Russia. Before Modi arrived, many had labeled this trip as a balancing act, saying that the trip to Moscow and the bear hug to Putin had damaged India's global standing. That's a Western pressure tactic wrapped in analysis and criticism, basically. But India does not see it like this. This visit to Ukraine underscores India's strong position in global affairs. It shows how India remains one of the few players that can engage with opposing sides while also reaffirming its own national interest.
Across continents, one powerful news source.
Bringing you diverse perspectives on the issues that matter.
We go beyond the boundaries to give you that little extra about every sporting moment.
So thank you for making First Post 5 million strong. We're counting on your support. And you can trust us to bring you the news unfiltered and unvarnished.
Climate change is on our doorstep. It's time for a revolution to take root. And it starts with 1.4 billion Indians. It starts with one tree. One tree for humanity. One tree for Mother Earth. One tree for our future. Project One Tree, a News 18 network initiative.
Hello, I'm Alex Green, coming to you from Durban, South Africa. Today we have a special show. Starting Hello and welcome to First Pulse America. I'm Eric Hamm, coming to you live from the nation's capital, Washington, D.C.